Hey guys, welcome back to Filter Coffee Football. Discussing the Arsenal result today. We had another video come up discussing all the other results of this weekend, and that'll be linked somewhere here in the description. But yeah, Arsenal 2, Crystal Palace 2. Very, very disappointing result. Neither of us are happy about the performance that the Gunners put on show. Vieira's team really did show up for the game, and it was an interesting match, to say the least. There were good things, there were bad things, but Karthik, why don't you start off with what you want to talk about the most for this match?
I want to say that I celebrated the equalizer. It was a extra time equalizer. You get a point out of nothing. I did celebrate it. If people call that mediocre or settling for mediocrity, then they can like sort off, because you don't really see those type of winners or those type of game-saving goals nowadays. Not as much. What I really want to focus on is, one of the biggest things I want to focus on is the bite that Alexander Lacazette brought in once he was subbed in. You saw that he was driving the team. He was getting the crowd excited, making those hand gestures, getting the team forward, playing that pivotal role where he was linking the ball. I mean, it was something that you expect your number 10 to do, but our number 10s are not really existent on that game. Lacazette did that. He was linking up well. He was linking up with Oba well. And for all his performances, I was really thinking he should get on the score sheet, which he eventually did. What do you think?
It was actually a really solid performance. Like he just added a whole different dimension to the attack. He was a lot more mobile than what our attack seemed to be at that point. You know, a lot of our players just seemed very static in their roles up front on the pitch. So when he came in, he really moved around a lot. He created a lot of half chances in there as well. I mean, there is lots of evidence to say that he should have probably scored or assisted well before he did. Interesting that you talk about the celebration portion, because I just recently learned this thing. So apparently at Manchester United, you don't celebrate an equalizer as a player. Which is, I think it's an amazing cultural thing, which is something that I aspire to be. I think that speaks volumes about the kind of character you're trying to build in a team. When an equalizer is not something you celebrate, it's something that's like, okay, we move on and we get better and we get a winner from that point on. Of course, at 90 plus whatever minutes, it wouldn't have made sense for us to rush back and stuff like that. But I like that's the kind of Arsenal I want to see. I want them to not be celebrating these moments. I want them to be like, okay, we have to do better than this and push on, because the stats really showed that Arsenal did have the better opportunities in this match. So again, the finishing was where we were lacking. The goals that we conceded, honestly, both of them started from individual errors, which is just, it's just really sad when you see goals like that being conceded, because you know it's these are the, and this has been an issue with Arsenal for years now, where a lot of the goals that they're conceding are issues that they have with themselves. It's not like they're facing up against a brilliant team. And not to say that Crystal Palace were not good. They were really good. They were really on song. The players were really in the zone. But when you give a team like that the edge to go ahead and score, they will take that opportunity. Your job is to not give them, is to make them work hard. And when you're not making the opposition work hard for their goals, it just further demoralizes you, sorry, as a team, which is what annoyed me the most about this performance. Because a lot of players did really good, like Ben White, apart from his potential role in that second goal, actually had a really good game. Gabriel had an amazing game. Tomiyasu was also pretty good in this game today. Thomas Partey kind of had an okay-ish game. Lokonga was great going forwards, but cannot handle the pressure yet. And again, he's new to the Premier League. I don't expect him to do that. Tierney had a fabulous game and he almost got us back sooner in the game. And it's just very unlucky to not get that goal. Pepe with a crucial performance today as well. Aubameyang got his goal as well. Lacazette performed well. The kids didn't do quite so well. Emile Smith Rowe was fairly ineffective. Odegaard was almost, I mean, I don't think him next to Partey, that formation just does
The
not
double
work for
pivot
him.
with Odegaard does not work. He's
Yeah.
not a double pivot player.
Exactly. And then Saka, I mean, let's talk about that incident. What do you think about that? The shot, the tackle, whatever the heck that was.
I don't know why the Premier League claims itself to be the best or most watched league or whatever they want to call it, because the refereeing decisions are atrocious. It's garbage. You have professional referees who get paid shit tons of money to not call that decision a foul, or rather, let's talk about the decision before. So James McArthur got away with an incident which would have probably been a yellow card any other day with any other referee in any other league. Let's just keep it at that, okay? So if you had shown that card to him, then he wouldn't have had considered this, or he wouldn't have had the audacity to take a wild swing at someone's legs, not a football. It was his leg. Saka was right in front of him. You just don't swipe at a player expecting that the player will just move and the ball will magically land onto your feet. This was blatant and this was very intentional. And if you tell me football is a contact sport, then please sort off. I can't use expletives here, but please. That's the most stupidest argument I ever hear for anything that's injury related or anything that is a foul. I always get this excuse that, oh, football is a contact sport. Oh, that was not intentional because he's never done it earlier. I mean, had Granit Xhaka done it, he would have been deported back to Switzerland with 50 red cards as a gift to him forever. That's how mad I am looking at that incident and looking at how incompetent referees are ruining the Premier League experience. And this has been the culture that has actually been breeding in the Premier League. This is the culture that's actually been breeding.
And it was,
Incompetent refereeing.
yeah, and it was clearly serious enough to where he had to be taken off. And it was surprising that very little was made of the entire incident. So it was not, it was just a very, very weird situation where I was really shocked as to why nothing more was done in that moment. And we will talk more about just the bad refereeing that we've seen across the season. Anyway, so we will get back to that later on in
I want
this
to
week and
add
talk
one more
about
line
that.
there. I want
Sure,
to add
yeah.
one more line here. So you need to notice that now, I mean, when there is a football discussion, even on other bigger platforms, bigger websites, on Twitter, on social media, you always have the name of the referee also come out. I mean, now people know names of the referees. How bad has that to be to, like, you need to know the name of a particular referee to predict how many good decisions you're going to get or how many bad decisions are you going to get? Why is there so much attention to someone who should actually be on the sidelines and just be officiating games? And another stat, Mike Dean is the most card happy referee ever. He's probably given 7% of all the red cards involved in the Premier League.
You're lucky
That
Granit
speaks
Xhaka didn't play
volumes about
today.
himself. Exactly the point, right? And the Premier League says that they are the best. Where? Best in what? I mean, you are using technology, but you've gone backwards. That's how bad the Premier League is. I'm sorry to say it, but you've used technology to become even bigger idiots than you already were.
Let's move away from the refereeing rant and let's end with just I want you to say one good thing about actually Crystal, not even one good thing, just one thing about Crystal Palace's performance today.
They pressed high, they pressed well, and they attacked at the most vulnerable spaces. And they knew Arsenal did not really have a proper double pivot. And they took advantage of that fact. And they capitalized on those two individual mistakes. Though credit to them for showing up to this game. Credit to them for keeping it all on it and not just leaving it to chance. That's what I want to say.
Yeah, I was really impressed with how motivated the players seem to be, how the youth seems to have dug in, and Arteta has been with the club over 2 years. Vieira has been with Palace for what, 3-4 months maybe, and already you're seeing a blueprint of the manager on the team, which is really impressive, and with a very fresh, very new squad as well. So I do have really high hopes for Crystal Palace, and I'm really happy that they're actually moving on. And this is a very impressive result, especially because even Wilfred Zaha wasn't playing. So to get this result without the club talisman on the pitch speaks volumes to what the future of the club might hold. And again, ending on Arsenal, it speaks poorly on us that when the opposition team doesn't even have their best player on the pitch, we can't seem to be getting a result, and that too at home. So here's hoping that the last couple of results are a learning curve, and Arteta picks up some pointers from there, and the players improve and get better from that on, because we really need to pick back up. Spurs versus Arsenal was a big turning point, and now they've kind of gone up and moved up ahead of us again. So it seems like the joyride hasn't quite yet begun. So hopefully it does soon enough.
Yeah, we'll figure that out on Friday afternoon. That's when our next game is. So
that's good.
Here's hoping. Yeah.
But yeah, that was us talking about a fairly poor result for Arsenal, a pretty good result for Crystal Palace. And join us again when we talk about Arsenal versus Aston Villa on Friday, when Arsenal finally come together and batter a very decent Villa side. And yeah,
hopefully somebody does not have excuses back after that.
Stay posted. Like, share, subscribe. Please comment down your thoughts below as well. And
follow us on our Instagram.
Yes, at Filter Coffee Foodie. And help us grow, help us improve. Thank you so much. Take care, guys. Have a great day. Bye.
Bye-bye.